3, 2, 1. Oh, who's the wizard? Hey, it's Jake, Wizard 4 at Midnight Science Club, and have I got a deal for you. I've got a couple science activities you can do at home with your friends or by yourself with items you can find around your house. And the first one is a special gas. Doesn't look like there's anything in this jar, but watch. Woo-wee, sweet. Let me show you how to make some of this stuff. You need 4 things: vinegar, baking soda, a glass, and a jar with a lid. So the first thing to do, pour 2 or 3 inches of baking soda in the bottom of a glass. It's sodium bicarbonate, and there's some CO2 hidden in that molecule. In order to release it, I'm gonna pour in some acid. In this case, acetic acid that's found in vinegar, and that causes a chemical reaction, and we can see evidence of that. Look at the bubbles, and those bubbles contain carbon dioxide gas. Let's see if I can indicate the presence of some carbon dioxide. I'm carefully gonna lower a lit match into the jar. Yep, it went out, look at that. That is sweet. You know, I have a fire extinguisher on the wall filled with carbon dioxide just for the express purpose of putting out a flame. That's kind of sweet. Carbon dioxide, lit match, out she goes. So now we know that there is a layer of carbon dioxide gas inside the beaker. I'm going to transfer it to this empty jar. I guess it's not empty, it's filled with air, isn't it? And very carefully, I'm gonna pour the gas into the jar. And the carbon dioxide is more dense, it's gonna go right in and push out some of the air. And I might have to do that 3 or 4 times to get this jar completely filled with carbon dioxide gas. And then I can put the lid on. Now I have a jar filled with carbon dioxide. Let me try it. See if I got enough CO2 in there to do it. Sweet. I like this. Wizard gas. I like to store it in jars, and you can store it in the house for years and just pull out a jar and dump it on a candle at any time to amaze your family and friends. Let them think you're a wizard. Aha. An interesting note, why does carbon dioxide put out a flame? It's very simple. The CO2 is more dense. It just pushes the air and the oxygen that's in the air out of the way. And that fire requires oxygen in order to burn. So I just push the O2 out of the way like that. That's why fire goes out. Well, that's neat. Now let's do an activity that doesn't require a special gas. We can just use air. You'll notice I've got some empty soda cans. I've got 2 of them on the hot plate, and I put about 1 inch of water. You can obviously see that the water is boiling. So I'm gonna grab a can, turn it upside down inside the cold water. There we go. Voila. Oh, that scared me. I'm an old man. Look at that. Something crushed that can. And let's just think that through. It wasn't the tongs. I took the tongs away, so I didn't crush it. What was touching that can that could have crushed it? Water and air. Well, believe it or not, on every square inch of that can, atmospheric air pressure is pushing at almost 15 pounds per square inch, 14.7 actually. And that's why I have a bowling ball setting here. My bowling ball right here weighs 14.7 pounds. On the outside of the can, each one of those has almost 15 pounds pushing on it. But why isn't it crushed right now? That's because there's air inside pushing out. It's in a balance. Well, if I could lower the air pressure inside, the air on the outside can crush the can. And that's exactly what happened. We created a low pressure inside the can by letting the steam condense back into liquid, creating a partial vacuum. Let's do that again, that's kind of cool. There's a bowling ball pushing on every square inch. Goodness sakes. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Oh! Who's the wizard? It's gonna come to mind, what if I had a bigger can? Would that work? It would take a lot of pressure. It works. Isn't that sweet? Air pressure crushed that can. I really enjoyed this time together. We did some neat activities with items you can find around the house. I hope that helped mitigate some of the boredom we're all experiencing during this virus event. I'm Jake at Midnight Science Club. If you'd like to see more activities like these, join us on Instagram at Midnight Science Club.